Say, here's a girl's name in Winchell's column.
Isn't she the girl who spent 3 months in the Pacific last summer with the Jack Benny show?
Oh, that's right. And anybody who can stand Jack Benny for 3 months deserves to be on the radio.
But where can you find this girl?
Oh, in radio, that's easy. You just say, here she is, and here she is, Miss Martha Tilton. Martha, I think that you deserve the presidential citation for outstanding bravery.
Well, all I did, Fred, was to try to entertain the boys. A lot of other actors have made the same trip.
Well, I know, Martha, but they didn't have to go with the gray ghost of Waukegan. You know, on those jungle islands, when Benny sat around with the monkeys, it must have looked like one man's family.
You and Jack were good friends.
Well, we used to be years ago. You know, when we were kids, little Jackie had no mittens. On cold days, I used to let him keep his hands in my pockets. Well, when we grew up, I couldn't seem to break him of the habit. One day, my boy scout knife, a fish hook, my Afrikaad, and 3 worms were missing. There were words.
Is that what started you fighting?
Oh, yes, Martha. That started the whole thing. Benny blew his top. I picked it up, brushed it off, and stuck it back on his scalp again. And from then on, it's been the battle of words. Tell me, are you going back with old Dorian Gray again?
Well, yes, I think Jack expects to go overseas again next summer.
Yes, Benny likes to play for servicemen. You know, at his age, it's less painful to lay powdered eggs.
Well, Jack sure got a kick out of it.
I just wanted to make sure. I thought everybody had left there for a minute.
Well, Jack sure got a kick out of playing to the boys in the foxhole.
Oh, now look, Martha. Benny played to people in foxholes when he was in vaudeville. The minute he used to walk on the stage with that fiddle, people would duck down under their seats and with their bare hands tunnel their way out of the theater. But playing all of those Pacific islands must have been a wonderful experience.
It was really exciting, Fred.
I can imagine.
And many days in the jungle, we had nothing to eat but coconuts.
Coconuts? It must have been good to get back and taste some real food.
Oh, yes. The first day back home, Mr. Benny invited us all to his house for dinner.
Really? What did you have?
Coconuts.
Coconuts. Well, you were lucky. I was at Benny's house for dinner the night he got back from Capistrano. I got the dark meat of one swallow. You know, that guy is tighter than the back of a fat lady's slacks.
Why, Fred, how can you talk that way? How can you talk like that about Warner Brothers' famous lover?
Famous lover? Martha, you are confusing Brother Benny with another Warner Brothers leading man whose objective isn't always Burma.
Have you seen Jack's new picture, The Horn Blows at Midnight?
Yes, The Horn Blows at Midnight, but the audience blows the minute the picture starts. But enough small talk about a small talent, Martha. I really dreamed you up here on the radio as the pride of the jukeboxes to sing a song. Now, what would you suggest?
I'd like to sing it.